Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping with low level design. So let's start. So from the name low level design, you can make out that it is an initial design of the software where the errors are not taken as seriously as they are taken in high level design, because while you're doing high level design, there you have to be very accurate, very precise, right? But in case of low level design, you are only designing the architecture, or you can say the blueprint of the software. So errors are okay, they are not taken as seriously, okay? So low level design is a component level design process that follows step by step refinement process. So in low level design, what we do is we work on each of the components separately and we try to develop them separately, maybe parallelly also. That is the advantage of low level design, and we try to completely work on each of the components before we start with the high level design, okay? So this process can be used for designing data structure, required software architecture and source code. So we use low level design for data structure, for designing the blueprint of the software, and also the source code related to each of the components, okay? Because we want everything in our hand before we start working on the actual software, okay? Here we are not working on the software, here we are working on the components, okay? Once we are complete with the components, okay, that this component will give us this functionality and we have the source code of that, then we can start working on the high level design, okay? So after you have completed with your low level design, you have the detailed overview or detailed data about each component, okay, before developing a software. So this is very beneficial when you are developing a big software, okay? So what are the types of low level design? There are three types. First is modularity. So modularity, I guess you know, but if you don't know, we just try to divide the software into different smaller modules depending upon their functionality or some other criteria, and then we try to define the relation between all of them, okay? So this is one of the most useful approach we use nowadays while we are designing a software, okay? Second is structure chart. So structure chart, I have made a video previously on it, you can watch that. So structure chart is the graphical representation of the working of the software, okay? So when we see the graphical working of our software, then we are able to better understand the working of our software, right? Rather than just reading the theory part, right? So that's why we make use of structure chart also with the modularity. So to better understand the working on the software, okay? So it will be beneficial for the developer. And next is pseudocode. Now pseudocode is the mixture of, you can say, English as well as the code, okay? It lies in between English and code. It is not proper code and not proper English, okay? It is not in between of them, okay? So pseudocode is like we try to define each of the components, that like where for loop will be used, where if else loop will be used, okay? But we don't work on the internal coding of this, okay? Internal coding is left for the actual programmer. Here we only write what is required, okay, in that program or in that software, okay? So the general things regarding the software is explained in pseudocode, and when the programmer programs, then it can take help of the pseudocode to program that particular software accurately. Okay, so this was all about low level design. So thanks for watching.